Good afternoon, Sarah. We're in a tiny little hamlet with fabulous views. And where are we exactly?
We are in the concelho, I guess, of Campello. And we're just 10 minutes from Castanheira de Pera. But we are in what is a beautiful little village. We're just giving you a taster here of the views, because you really are 10 minutes from a town which has all facilities, plus quite a famous river beach. Of course, the wind's getting us from here, but we've got the river beach, which has actually got a wave machine, and it's got boats and all sorts of things there. And we've started here because also this village, a lot of the smaller villages have been sort of semi-abandoned. The same thing happened in England and Wales and all over the world. But this one has actually got 99% of the houses are lived in.
I think all of them.
All of them. Yeah, I didn't want to say that. You'll probably find one. Someone will correct us. and so this is actually the public space for the village. And the property is right there.
Yeah, 10 metres from your garden gate.
So although you've got a lovely courtyard garden at the back of the property, the owner says they've had numerous parties here. It's a very great place. You've got lots of shade, especially in the afternoon when it's hot.
No, it's perfect. Thank you.
You've got the tables and you've got the barbecue. And actually, you can have your little festa here and go home to a tidy house, which I would consider to be a major benefit.
Yeah, that would be a major benefit. Yeah.
Right. So, just to give you an idea of here, and then we'll walk across to the property, shall we?
Yes, we shall. You've got children, obviously. Small children, that would be a huge bonus, 10 metres from the gate as well.
They're going to put a new one in.
Yeah. Yeah, there's also...
Yeah, actually, you'd think the kids would come and make a den here or something, wouldn't you?
Yeah. But there's also a spring right there.
Yes, this is the other important point, is that this is a natural water source. It's actually plumbed into the property. You still pay for it. But because it's from natural spring coming out of the rock, the water board come and test it every day.
Yeah, every single day.
So you've got very, very good quality, pure water. Yeah. And it tastes just...
No chlorine, nothing.
Okay. So the land plot here, which is literally just got some olive trees and actually beautiful vines there. But this doesn't belong.
Yeah, that's not included in the property. It's basically...
And the property starts here. Now, I've got a large driveway. We'll show you from the inside. There's two separate doors and then the garage door.
Yeah.
And then this is very pretty, but low maintenance. You've got lots of lovely flowers and the grapes are going bonkers.
Yeah, there's that many plants. It's actually difficult to get a shot of the house. But
actually, I can't get in the gate. Oh, yes, I can. Right. Come on in. Now, they've got three beautiful dogs here. One of them's here. And we assume he's not going to bark at us, but might do.
Yeah, she'll calm down if she does.
Lovely lurches. So, here we are in what is the front garden. Two rows of grapes there. Paved area.
That's going to be a lot of grapes, isn't it?
It is. I haven't asked if there's... And there's another load on the other side, but then obviously not ours, or the belonging to the property. They're very low maintenance, but pretty attractive. And I don't know, it might be slightly better for you now, actually, to just turn around and get a shot there. The light's slightly different than it was 10 minutes ago. It wasn't your friend then, was it? Absolutely.
No, the sun's moved a little bit and you can get the views. Yeah. A little bit better.
Lovely place to sit. And upstairs has the balconies from the bedrooms as well. We're in a large property. We have 5 to 6 bedrooms, 2 lounges, 3 bathrooms. We have these beautiful tiles. Really.
Yeah, traditional.
Height. Great height.
Fantastic ceiling.
So we shall go into, right, here's the dog. Don't tread on the dog.
Don't tread on the dog.
So, a lovely lounge area here, and I happen to particularly like the owner's sense of style. We've got some beautiful furniture here, but we're not looking at the furniture, we're looking at the size of the room. So that's a huge corner sofa there.
Yeah.
Two large
shelving units.
Yes, let's call them that. And a bookshelf. So that's lounge one. And as we come through, well, I think you just go in there. We have bathroom with bathtub and shower.
Yeah, it's a really good sized bathroom. And as Sarah says, full-size bath.
If you wanted to put a screen across there and have a power shower put in, it'd be easy to do.
No problem.
Yeah, plenty of space. Okay. There's a bedroom there. I think we'll do that just before we go up the stairs.
Okay.
That's just under stairs storage.
Yeah.
So then we come into what is, well, it's probably seasonal. I'd say the main lounge in the winter with the wood burner going.
Yeah, I mean, it's big enough.
It's got a lovely dining.
Diner, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, more than big enough. I'm going to try and get around.
Get the depth of it all in.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh, what have you done?
I haven't done anything.
Good.
Nothing wrong, anyway.
I
don't think. Just to get the whole of the room, because this is enormous.
Yeah, it's big. And the fireplace is lovely with the bricks around there. And we have a marble top. And again, the tiles actually come through the whole house. And they're one of those designs that they're not, some of the designs are just too much, but these just sort of blend, and they've decorated the house very nicely, so it just blends together.
Beautifully done.
It's worth pointing out that door is one of the exit doors that you can see. There's two, aren't there?
Right, okay.
So that goes to the driveway.
Right, directly onto the driveway.
Directly onto the driveway, and then there's another one out there. Okay. Now, if we come through here...
One moment. I'm just going to point out the log-burning fire.
I don't know why I'm rushing.
Log-burning fire there. So...
And it's
I'm going to turn around again so that you get the full effects of the room from this direction. Yeah.
Yeah, and from here, the fact that it just flows, you can see straight through into the other lounge. So.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll reverse into.
You reverse, and I'll move out of the way.
Yeah, this cameraman is reversing.
Ta-da!
Ta-da!
So a really good sized kitchen with yet another burner. There was me thinking you might get cold. No,
never in a million. No.
Huge burner there. And the stack pipes go through probably not this one, but the other one goes through to the upstairs.
Yeah.
So that keeps upstairs warm.
Yeah.
If you had both of these going and the doors open in the boiler. So
it's a big kitchen.
Plenty of storage.
The same, right. Kitchen, diner as well. I mean, there's just tons of actual living space here, isn't there?
I just have to say, I have to send this one to Charlotte, who's my only other person who's got the chair like this that I know. Hi, Charlotte. In here...
Hang on, Sarah.
We have...
I'm just going to...
Oh, I'm rushing. Why am I rushing?
Yeah, I don't know what you're rushing. But there's your kitchen in all its glory. And now for something rather less glorious.
You'd end up using the kitchen table a lot, wouldn't you? Then when you've got dinner parties.
Yeah.
Right, blinding me. Now, what we have here is an area that's used basically as husband's workshop. But what it actually is another bathroom, which they don't use. The lady owner is a little bit, oh, don't go in there, it's terrible. But it's just used as storage. But what it would be, I think, huge, larger, and a bathroom. Now this bathroom actually has another door going out to the courtyard. So we'd have a door on here, wouldn't you? So outside in the
outside toilet.
You just come in here and wanted the toilet.
Yeah, outside bathroom.
And larder. I think this would probably just be a huge larder.
But unless you wanted a workshop.
Fridge, freezers, whatever in there, washing machines, it could all go in this room here.
Yeah. Although you don't need to, because it's just so big, isn't it? The kitchen's huge. You don't actually need to save space in it, but I love larders, so I would have a larder. But there we go.
Fairness, I can't find that.
Can't find what?
Dishwasher, washing machine.
They're in a separate room.
He doesn't go to the font and do her washing.
They're outside.
Right, come on then. So we've got, it is out here. So it's just you don't have to go far at all to hang your washing up. So that's the other door going onto the driveway.
Yeah.
Yep. And then yet another place to sit. Paved. Very pleasantly.
Yeah.
Pool table, we have checked and we can confirm to husband that we have given it 100% level. And I would like to come and have a game, please. And
it is actually, I want to point out, a garage. Because there are, in fact, the garage doors. So if you want to keep your car undercover, this is actually a garage.
Obviously, put to much better use. Pool table.
Yeah, I mean, Sarah definitely loves pool tables more than garages.
So, loads of space.
Yeah.
So it's very low maintenance because most of the area is paved, but you do have a lot of outside space.
Yeah,
totally. And
utility room to the left.
This is, in fact, the utility room. Washing line's right here.
I mean, at first I think it's a bit odd to have your washing machine and dryer outside, but
well, it's not really.
No, it makes perfect sense. Yes.
It's undercover.
Yeah.
And that's the toilet to the bathroom that's not used. It's currently a little bit shabby. So, but if you're out here entertaining, you just go straight in there. You don't have to take through the house.
You do not.
Obviously, you don't have a problem with water.
No.
Because you've got this drainage area here.
Yeah.
And, well, I think it's probably time to look upstairs, isn't it?
Let's go and have a look upstairs.
Don't forget that first bedroom. I'll come and open the door for you. So the one bedroom downstairs, I mean, obviously, if you had someone who needed to be on one floor, if you had elderly parents or what else, someone who was disabled or something like this, you could actually have two bedrooms on the floor because you've got your huge lounge and your huge kitchen.
I mean, that's a big double bedroom there, really, isn't it? Yes.
But this is also
a nice size double bedroom.
All the rooms are good sizes.
Yeah, all the rooms are very good sizes with excellent ceiling heights.
Yeah. But with four bedrooms upstairs, this could easily be an office. It just depends what you want to use it for. You've got 5 to 6 bedrooms. 5 set-up bedrooms.
It's a whopper.
It is. Go on then, don't tread on the door. I'm so sorry.
You're telling me I need to tread on the door.
Yeah, then I tread on the
and
door.
And then you're the one that's sorry. The dog. But there we go.
You're like Henry.
Okay, up the stairs we go. Again, really lovely tiles on the way up.
They are completely throughout the property, not the bathroom. Not the bathroom, but everywhere else. So,
Sarah's place behind me. I'll open my own doors.
Poor thing. And you'll fall in the house.
Yeah. Right, we'll go left, as is our habit.
I love the decor.
Yeah, the decor is excellent.
Obviously, that's personal taste.
Yeah, but it is very Sarah.
Glimpse of the views there. There you go.
Yeah, I'm just going to do
room in.
I'm just going to do a pan of the bedroom. And again, it's a really, really big double, isn't it?
Yeah, they are actually. All
you know, because that's not a small bed and it's dwarfed by the room.
Yeah. And then, are we going to come out here?
Yeah.
Because of course, if you can, the sun's a little bit in your eyes there.
Yeah.
But I mean, how peaceful is this?
I think it's just about okay now. I think we can drink, in fact, excuse me a moment, because I'm going to pan all the way around just so you get the full view from the bedroom balconies, because they're worth looking at.
They are. Really, really we could just
absolutely fabulous.
And it is incredibly peaceful.
Yeah. Is that door open?
Yeah, it is.
Okay. Well, that's really handy. Ooh.
What?
There's another one of those.
Another chair, yeah. They're brown, I think, and they're actually, they've got the pair.
Yeah.
Hi, Charlotte, again. Probably never watched one of our videos. I'll make her. Right, huge room.
Absolutely.
Actually, when we think about it, it's equal to one next door, isn't it?
Probably.
Yeah, just the colours make it look slightly different. Beautiful. As you can see, lots and lots of space.
They're just really big, aren't they? Absolutely fabulous spaces. And again, even upstairs, slightly slopey ceiling.
Yeah, but that gives it the height, doesn't it? Which is giving us the sense of space.
Yeah, it gives them more sense of space. And even on the narrow, the less high side, yeah, it's still normal, enormous.
I mean, that's normal ceiling height.
Yeah. Oh, I think it's above normal ceiling height. Okay.
So
the bathroom.
The one bathroom up here. And this one just has the shower, which is fine.
Yeah. Cool. Nice shower cubicle. Again, it, you know, it's a decent sized bathroom.
Yep. Now, these rooms are slightly smaller, but still good for us.
Yeah, these are like normal sized doubles, aren't they? Just after being in the the other ones.
I think these is like, you get so many of these in Portugal. I think it must have come from Mozambique, you know, the Portuguese connection with Mozambique, because that's like
the hardwood. Yeah.
Yeah, you find them in quite a lot of old houses.
Yeah, the older big was, I mean, it's not that old a house, but.
No, but the furniture.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's going down on the courtyard.
And the views, because.
Ah, well, now you've got the ceiling in, I'm going to have to explain something. Or the roof in, is because. The reason those planks are on the roof on the right-hand side is because he's been pointing up.
Yeah, the ridge.
So that's why they're there, no other reason. Just for doing a little bit of work on the ridge of the property. While it's dry, good for maintenance. I'm lost here. Excuse me.
Okay.
Actually, this is big again. So that's the smallest room. Yep, this is a good one.
Yeah. In fairness, they're all really good, aren't they?
Yeah.
Absolutely fabulous sizes, both in width, length, and height.
Are you waffling?
No, I am waffling.
Can't find something else. Yeah. But we've got four very good sized bedrooms up here. Oh, gosh. And I'm tripping over everything. Dogs, rugs. And we should mention that the owner has applied for an AOL license for the property. So,
if you didn't want that, you could just discontinue
that. But if you did want it, then it's in the process.
It's in the process, yeah. So what we're doing?
Oh, good point. Standing in the hallway at the moment.
I know.
Yeah.
Just to go back out on the balcony.
We could.
I'm
not going to sing. Oh, my favourite bedroom. Let's go in here.
Okay. Sarah on the bed, is it?
No, we are not.
It's not doing that. Okay.
What was her name? Paulie Yates.
Paulie Yates, that is it.
Right. So, no, we're not doing that. Anyway, I don't have Michael Huntington anywhere near me, unfortunately. Large property, beautiful location, very peaceful, proper, very friendly hamlet, unusual little properties are lived in. So there's a sense of community here. There is a bar 5 minutes drive away, and then Castanera for all big supermarkets and everything. So I think you can see for yourself the plus points of the property. So I will wind it up by saying thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Please do like and subscribe.